Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to our picnic by the Serpentine.
Welcome back. You are watching Queen the Greatest, a weekly celebration of some of Queen's most memorable songs, performances, and achievements. This week, we head back to 1976, and what remains to this day one of the biggest nights in Queen's remarkable career. Humbled by the success they had enjoyed so far, the band wanted to do something special to say thank you to their loyal fans. And what better way than to put on their most spectacular show to date, a free concert in the heart of London, Hyde Park. As Brian explains in this interview from The Time, it proved to be a massive undertaking.
It took a lot of people about 8 or 9 weeks solid work, including us. All the traumas from not being able to get permission to do it, you know, to wondering about whether the grass was okay. Remember there was a drought
yes.
at that time, and they didn't want us to play if it didn't rain, which is kind of an unusual thing. Nobody realising how long it took to do, to prepare for a thing like that. You can just sort of put it on and off in the day. Lots of things like that. Right up to the last moment, getting very incredibly naturally kind of high before going on, because it was, although we played to large audiences before, this is London, it's our home. Mm. And that's something different.
Despite all the obstacles, the show went ahead. And as this footage from a rare BBC News clip shows, it was a major event.
More than 50,000 people flocked to the free concert, which was remarkably peaceful, with only 4 arrests over a period of 9 hours. The police presence was kept to a minimum, with only 40 officers visible, though at least twice as many out of sight in reserve. The star band went on at dusk, Queen. Queen spent £50,000 of their own money to promote the concert. It may be only rock and roll, but it is expensive.
In fact, the crowd size was estimated to be somewhere between 150 and 200,000 people. And for 80 minutes, Queen rocked London. However, as the band prepared to give the ecstatic crowd an encore to finish the night, the police stepped in.
Afterwards, being threatened with arrest if we went on for the encore, which nobody realised at the time, but we were sort of hustled into a van on threat of being taken away to different places. It was very strange, because I think people got nervous of the crowd, and people worried whether it could be controlled in the dark and things like that. But apart from things like that, it was great.
Yeah, you were pleased with it on the day.
I was very pleased, yeah.
A night like this needed to be preserved, and so the concert was filmed, with footage from it immediately used in a promotional video for Somebody to Love. Looking back at it more recently, Brian recalls what a big step the Hyde Park show was for Queen, and the significance that night had for the band.
I remember thinking, ooh. Gulp, you know, we've carved out a place around the world, but England doesn't really think we're that cool. It was packed beyond belief, and it was really like coming home to a sort of hero's welcome. It was a thrilling experience to actually have that kind of contact with an audience in your own hometown.
Nearly 30 years later, in 2005, Brian and Roger would make an emotional return to Hyde Park with Paul Rodgers. Originally scheduled for the 8th of July, the show had to be delayed due to a terrorist attack in the city. However, a week later, undeterred, everyone came together for another memorable night, with this poignant moment a particular highlight.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. above us on the sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. No religion too. Yeah! Imagine all the people
You big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing, we are.